Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 5.5, Problem 4. This is Section 5.5, Problem number 4. It asks us to compute 5 permutation 1 and 5 combination 1. So for the permutation, first we have to have the permutation formula. N permutation R is equal to N factorial, N factorial over, in parentheses, N minus R factorial. So for this particular problem, the N is 5. The larger value is the N, and the R, the smaller value, is 1. So as I put that into my formula, N factorial will be 5 factorial. Then in my parentheses, N minus R will be 5 minus 1, in parentheses, factorial. So as with any type of math, when you have parentheses, you must do your work in parentheses first. So I'll leave the 5 factorial on top just for a sec. And underneath 5 minus 1 will be 4 factorial. So now I can do out the factorials. 5 factorial is 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. And in the denominator, 4 factorial is 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. And now you can cancel 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 in the top and in the bottom, leaving you with just 5. So 5 permutation 1 is equal to 5. So what that's telling us is if you have 5 things to choose from, there are 5 different ways you can choose one. Well, the order doesn't matter. I mean, you're only choosing one and there's no repeats. In general, whenever the second number is 1, the answer is whatever the first number is. So N permutation 1 equals N. So 72 permutation 1 will be 72. 12 permutation 1 will be 12. When the second number is 1, the answer is whatever the first number is. And you'll see we're going to get a similar result for the combination. Watch what will happen. So the combination formula is N combination R equals N factorial over, in parentheses, N minus R factorial. And in front of the parentheses, you have times R factorial. So it's pretty similar with this extra addition of the R factorial. So again, the N is the larger value for this problem is 5. The R is the smaller value for this problem, 1. So fill that in. So on top, N factorial will be 5 factorial. In front of the parentheses, R factorial will be 1 factorial. Inside the parentheses, N minus R will be 5 minus 1 with a factorial. So let me do my work in parentheses first. So the 5 factorial in the numerator will stay for a minute. The 1 factorial in the bottom will stay for a minute. The parentheses will get replaced with a 4 factorial. 5 minus 1 is 4. And we have the factorial. So now, if you do that out, 5 factorial on the top is 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. In the denominator, 1 factorial is 1. Times 4 factorial is 4 times 3 times 2 times 1.
And you could multiply all that out and reduce it, but it's just so much easier to cancel 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 on the top and in the bottom.
I'm left with 5 over 1, which is really 5. So 5 combination 1 is 5. Again, you get that same shortcut that once you do it once or twice, you can apply it whenever you really need to. Whenever the second number is 1, for permutation or combination, the answer is whatever the first number is. So 63, let's say, combination 1 would be 63. Or 44 combination 1 would be 44. When the second number is 1, the answer is whatever the first number is for both permutation and combination. That's a nice shortcut.